but give me Park Avenue.
The chores.
That's going to be stuck in the head for the rest of the day. Welcome back to the Rhode Show. This morning in the buzz, we are saying goodbye to suburban life. That's according to some new research. More people are moving out of the burbs and into the city. The shift was released by a Census Bureau showing that the U.S. urban core is getting denser, while far-flung suburban areas are seeing their growth dwindle. So we wanted to know, where would you rather live?
Currently? I would like to live in a city.
Yes.
For a short time.
Right.
I would not want to settle down in a city.
No.
By any means.
Right.
I enjoy a yard. Mm-hmm. I enjoy, you know, not... The hustle and bustle is fun, maybe for a short time, for me personally.
Right.
I like the accessibility of being in a city and being able to pretty much walk wherever you want.
Right.
And do some exploring. If and when I settle down,
yep,
it's going to be, well, when? I know it's going to happen. Someway, if I ever decide to settle down. When I do decide to settle down, it's going to be, I like the suburbs.
Right.
Like things being a bit more rural and
yeah,
it's just relaxed, low key.
Yep.
I like having the comfort of your own mm-hmm. home.
Growing up, when I was younger, we had a lot of family who lived in New York City. I'd
yep
be in the city a lot. Growing up, I always thought that I would be in the city
mm-hmm.
and move to the city. I love the city. I think, like you said, it's different when you have kids, although I know a lot of people who have kids who live in the city and they're perfectly fine.
Yeah.
They have a great life. The kids know their way around the city.
Mm-hmm.
But for me, right now, you know, I love where I am now. I love having a house, like you said. I love having the yard. It's more responsibility. It's a lot of responsibility taking care of that stuff. I think having kids growing up in a suburban area, depending on where it is always good. But man, you know, to be a kid who's able to grow up in a city, even if it was New York or someplace like that, Boston's any place, I think it's a kind of a cool life to have.
I think you're exposed to a lot.
Yeah, you're exposed to so many different things, so many different, you know, restaurants, so many different cultures.
Mm-hmm.
I think if I was a kid, yeah, I would have loved to have grown up in a city like that.
Yeah. It is very fun. And there are advantages either way. I think we're seeing this shift,
sure,
though, a lot now, because studies are also showing that, okay, folks are either getting married later in life,
right,
not having kids,
yeah,
so maybe they don't live that type of lifestyle.
Right.
And maybe, yeah, having less upkeep,
sure,
and living in an apartment is a lot easier.
It could be easier. Yeah, you don't have to have that responsibility.
Brendan, city or suburb?
I've lived in both. I think I'm a suburb kind of guy overall. The city,
right,
was fun, but I like being able to get in my car and just go,
yeah,
you know, even though the price of gas is outrageous. But that's another buzz topic for another day. Well, here's what our Facebook friends are saying about this topic today. Lynn Jackson Rossier kicks off the comments this week saying, in the suburbs, because I don't like the craziness of the city.
There you go. Crazy,
I never
little
that.
Crazy. Donnie Bennett continues, when I lived in Providence, I used to listen to loud music for hours and hours and hours, every day and every night. But that's only because I had no choice since my neighbors controlled the volume. That's the worst. Now I live peacefully in the suburbs. Guess which one I love better. And last but not least, Bethany Hashway closes things out with city, because there's more action and more places to see and visit.
It is
there
exciting.
You go. The people have spoken. That's what they had to say. Well,